I'm Henny Espinosa, and this is your TFC News Now.
We begin with wicked weather battering the Northern California mountains with heavy snow and winds of up to 100 miles per hour. The National Weather Service issued blizzard warnings for the Sierra Nevada through Sunday night, and more snow is expected to drop in the area on Monday. A Filipino family from the San Francisco Bay Area was vacationing in South Lake Tahoe for the weekend when they got caught in the intense blizzard. Husband and wife Edwin and Mary Joy Asis and their three children, Stephen, Scarlett, and Skyler, were about to head home on Sunday when they realized the roads were much more dangerous to drive. Authorities shut down 100 miles of Interstate 80, citing extremely dangerous to impossible travel conditions. There were also brief closures on Highway 50 for avalanche control.
It was a blizzard. It's pretty scary. And we had actually followed another car, the Acura car. That car was like starting to skid. I was driving carefully because it was dark and scary.
Thank you very much.
In U.S. politics, former U.S. President Donald Trump welcomed the decision by the U.S. Supreme Court barring states from disqualifying candidates for federal office under a constitutional provision involving insurrection and reversing Colorado's exclusion of him from its ballot.
Essentially, you cannot take somebody out of a race because an opponent would like to have it that way. And it has nothing to do with the fact that it's the leading candidate, whether it was the leading candidate or a candidate that was well down on the totem pole, you cannot take somebody out of a race.
The justices unanimously overturned a December 19 decision by Colorado's top court to kick the former president off the state's Tuesday Republican primary ballot after finding that the U.S. Constitution's 14th Amendment disqualified him from again holding office. The Colorado court had found that Trump took part in an insurrection for inciting and supporting the January 6th 2021 attack on the U.S. Capitol by his supporters. The ruling was issued on the eve of Super Tuesday, the day in the U.S. presidential primary cycle when most states hold party nominating contests. Tuesday, March 5th is California's primary election. At least four Filipino Americans are seeking major offices in Los Angeles County and are making a last pitch to voters. Jessica Calosa is the former Los Angeles Public Works Commissioner and current Deputy Chief of Staff for Attorney General Rob Bonta. She looks to be the first Filipina to be elected in the California State Assembly District. She is running in the state's 52nd District, which covers parts of northeastern and eastern Los Angeles. Housing rights attorney Isabel Jurado hopes to be the first Filipino elected to the Los Angeles City Council. She is vying for the City Council's 14th District. Immigration attorney-turned-Claremont lawyer Jed Liano is running for the State Assembly's 41st District that covers Pasadena to the foothills. Health advocate and cybersecurity expert Kurt Jose is hoping to be the third Filipino to become a U.S. congressman as he vies to represent California's 31st District, which is located in San Gabriel Valley.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Stay with us, Kapamilya.